Hi everyone, this is Maverick Paul, the Chemistry Guru. Now in this video, we want to go through the nucleophilic addition mechanism of carbonyl compounds. Now the first thing we want to talk about is to deduce why would carbonyl compound undergo nucleophilic addition reactions. Now as mentioned in previous videos involving mechanisms of other functional groups, what we can do is we can deduce the nature of the mechanism based on the charge of the carbon and the degree of saturation of carbon. So same goes for carbonyl compounds. We can do the same thing. Now if we look at the first portion, why would carbonyl compounds undergo nucleophilic reaction? It's very simple. I look at the charge of carbon. Carbon is attached to oxygen, which is more electronegative. Oxygen is a delta minus charge. Carbon is a delta positive charge. So what this means is carbon will attract a nucleophile, which is negatively charged. You attract a carbon, which is positively charged. The second portion, why would carbonyl compound undergo addition reaction? We look at the degree of saturation of carbon. This carbon is unsaturated. So what it can do is it can undergo addition reaction. It just takes in the nucleophile. It can retain all the other groups that are already attached to this carbon. So just like alkene, carbonyl compounds will undergo addition reaction. Now let's look at the mechanism proper. We have this equation involving this carbonyl compound. In this case, it is an aldehyde. But for ketones, the mechanism is exactly the same. Reacting with HCN to give us this product, cyanohydrin. Now this reaction is done using trace NaOH or trace NaCN at 10 to 20 degrees C. So let's run through the mechanism. In general, we have three steps. The first step is to generate the nucleophile, which is CN minus or nitrile in this case. Now depending on whether we are using trace NaOH or trace NaCN, the first step will be slightly different. Now if you are using trace NaOH, then what we need to do is we need to write out an acid-base reaction between NaOH and HCN. So the equation will look something like this. NaOH reacting with HCN, which is an acid, you give us Na plus CN minus, which is our nucleophile, and water. So the nucleophile nitrile is generated in this case from this acid-base reaction. Of course, acid-base reaction occurs readily, so this will be the first step. Now, if we are using trace NaCN, then it is a lot more straightforward. Trace NaCN will just be NaCN dissociate to give us Na plus and CN minus. So same thing, the nucleophile is generated. And because this step is just the dissociation of NaCN, this step would also be the first step. Now one thing to note is nitrile is the catalyst in this case, so later it would be regenerated. So therefore, in terms of the amount of NaCN, we don't need to add a lot. I just need to add a trace amount because it is the catalyst. NaOH is the reactant that ultimately generates this catalyst. So I don't need too much catalyst. So in turn, I don't need a lot of sodium hydroxide. So same reason, the amount of NaOH required would just be trace amounts because it is used to generate the catalyst, which is also required in trace amounts. All right, the next step will be the nucleophilic attack on the carbonyl compound. So the carbonyl compound we have is our aldehyde. So I'll just draw out the aldehyde in this case. Then the CN minus would come in. CN minus will attack the carbon, which is a partial positive charge. So I can put the delta positive charge on carbon, partial minus charge on oxygen. We draw a lone pair on carbon. We draw an arrow pointing to carbon because later we will form a carbon-carbon bond. So the carbon is the one that is acting as the nucleophile and attacks the carbonyl carbon. So once this happens, we also need to draw an arrow in this case to show that the two electrons inside the carbon-oxygen pi bond will be broken. Both electrons will go to oxygen. So this is our slow step. What I'll form is I'll form a carbon-carbon bond. So this nitrile is added to carbon. I'll have a CH3. Then the nitrile is here, the hydrogen will be here. Then as mentioned, this C double bond O, because the pi bond will break, both electrons will go to oxygen, the negative charge will be passed on to oxygen. I'll end up with a oxygen which is negatively charged. So this is our intermediate, which is not very stable because oxygen is negatively charged. So that will prompt us to the next step, which is the protonation of this intermediate, and I regenerate the catalyst. Alright, so the next step will be on the protonation of the intermediate. As mentioned, this guy is not very stable because I have an O- here. So what will happen is it will steal a hydrogen from HCN. So we will draw out HCN, which is the reactant in this case. Hydrogen will be a partial positive charge. Carbon will be a partial minus charge. So the oxygen will use a lone pair. Attack the hydrogen, forms a bond with hydrogen, it will be an OH bond. And then this CH bond will break both electrons to go to carbon. So later, I'll form a CN minus here. Of course, this step will be the fast step because this intermediate is highly unstable, so it will trigger this protonation very readily. So this is a fast step. So the product that I'll end up having will be CH3, a carbon with an OH group, a hydrogen. The nitrile is here, so this is the product cyanohydrin, and we'll end up with a CN minus, which is the catalyst that is being regenerated. Alright, so that was the step-by-step mechanism for nucleophilic addition reaction of carbonyl compounds. If you learned something useful from this video, please give me the thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more weekly video lessons. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.